How many of you have donated blood this year? We're only into March, however, you'd be surprised at the lack of people that are donating blood. Let's talk a little bit more about donation. Currently, there are 324 billion people in the United States. Out of those 324 million, there's one birth every 8 seconds. That's according to the American Red Cross. How many of you have ever needed blood? It's not a lie, but you'd be surprised. There's a shortage of blood donations here. It doesn't cross our minds to donate, but today I'm going to share with you a little bit of information about blood donation. So as I said before, we are in a constant shortage. Blood donations just does not cross our mind. Every 3 seconds, somebody needs blood. 1 out of every 10 people entering a hospital will need blood by the time they're done their hospital stay. We go through 32,000 pints of blood daily. Blood Drive Facts, as located online, shows that 4.5 million Americans will require a blood transfusion at some point in their lifetime. Let me ask you another question. How many of us here have ever needed any surgery, whether that was elective or emergency surgery? For that elective surgery, did it ever cross your mind to go ahead and donate blood before you went in? Perhaps not if you're like the most of us. Perhaps we don't know as much about blood as we'd hoped, about the types of donations, what's available to us, what's not available to us, and actually how easy it is to donate blood. There are some common myths surrounding blood donation. A lot of people are under the assumption that blood donation will actually decrease your strength, which is just not true. Damgaard et al. Conducted a study which showed that the disease contraction is actually very, very low. We do not contract diseases by going ahead and donating blood. The most common bloods that are here in our population are O and B. They also fall into O, B, A, and AB. According to Crawford et al., over half of all Americans fall under that O-positive blood type. What does that mean for us? O-positive is a universal donor. So what that means is out of 50% of all of us here, 50% of you will need that O-positive blood type. What does that mean for donations exactly? Let's take a further look. So whole blood donation is the most common type of donation you will do at a blood drive or a blood bank. You go in, donate for 10 minutes, take your cookies, and then be on your way home. What they do with that blood afterwards, they separate it. Red blood cells, platelets, plasma, and double red cell donations. Those can all be extracted from that one donation you decide to give. That whole blood donation can be done every 8 weeks, and that blood donated can be used for up to 42 days. Platelets, unfortunately, will only survive for 5 days. So that plasma and platelet donation, what they do is they take your blood, run it through a machine, take what they need, and then send back to you what they don't need. Those platelets are very important for cancer survivors. Cancer survivors require platelets to clean their blood and transfuse them with new life. That plasma can also be frozen for up to 1 year. There's also something called a double red blood cell donation. That donation is good for people who do not have a lot of time, however, want to go ahead and give what they can when they can. What happens with that is the machine takes the double red blood cells from your blood, sends back to you the liquids, along with an extra little bit of saline, and when that happens, some donors have actually said that they've been more hydrated after they've donated the blood than before they went in. That specific blood donation can only be done every 4 months, and only takes approximately 30 minutes longer than that original blood donation of 10 minutes. So you may be asking yourself, why is blood donation so low and our population is so high? Well, Crawford et al. Decided to do a little study into that and found that 60% of all Americans, that's 60%, are eligible to donate blood. However, only 5% are donating what they can. 17% of those non-donors have decided that never really crossed their mind to go ahead and donate blood. 15% of those non-donors have said they just do not have the time. This is unacceptable, as 1 in 7 people will need blood. 4.5 million people will need a blood-saving transfusion by the time they're done. What does that mean for us? Here in Southern California, out of 10,000 people, only 3.5 people are donating blood. The highest donation bracket is in the age group of 45 to 64. Those are the baby boomers. The lowest donations, interestingly enough, are coming from the fastest growing populations. Those of us who fall into that 18 to 24 year age. talked about the universal donor. A universal donor is O positive. What does that mean for us? 57% of all Latinos fall into that O positive category, 51% of all African Americans, and 45% of all Caucasians. Most of us do donate after terrorism attacks, shootings, natural disasters, that kind of thing. However, it's still not enough. It's not enough to maintain what we have, nor is it enough to deal with an extreme emergency situation. Although donations are on a decline, they're simple, they're easy, they're fast, we still are not doing what we can. So I urge you, walk into a room next time. Out of 30 people sitting there, 2 of you will need blood by the end of your lifetime. And I ask you, when it's time for you to need blood, who is going to have the time? Thank you.